Black spending matters.
Black spending matters.
Black spending matters.
You know, if we can be able to facilitate the black dollar and put it all together, maybe we can start building empires that way.
How do you feel about how black people spend money today?
Too many of us are consumers.
Spending definitely matters.
Black spending matters.
Rose can't grow if you limit the water it receives. If you control what a person knows, you can mold what they believe. If you diminish the education of the underprivileged and poor, this creates an expectation that crime or entry-level occupation is all that life has in store. If you raise the rich to be sophisticated and superfluity, anything foreign to their familiarities is forlorn. This disables their opportunity to be aware of cultures and communities different from the one in which they were born. If you teach a man to hate the color of his skin, though made in God's image, his cultural identity is smothered by hatred of oneself and others, backstabbing one's own brothers in pursuit of privilege. Like water helps in cultivation, every single rose, people are products of information to which they are exposed. Thank you.
Peace, my name is DeMareon. A lot of people know me as Brother Gibson. I'm a polymathic wordsmith. I write books, films, songs, whatever. And this is my first book right here. It's called Looking Forward. It's available on my website.
Hold it up.
My small business, I'm saying, forwardpublishinghouse.com. Stay tuned there. We have a lot of books coming out this year. So, this is what I do. I produce these books. I make them. I copyright them, I write them, and I distribute them to the people without no corporate interference and none of that. I have a children's book coming out. Hopefully in the summertime. And it's for black children.
So, like, what is the book Looking Forward about?
Looking Forward, it is a collection of poems that are all daily affirmations, like stuff you can look at the beginning of your day or at the end of your day. That can just motivate you to keep going forward and keep pushing towards your dreams, to keep pushing towards the goals that you have, and just keep a good outlook, you know what I'm saying, despite all the stuff that's going on.
What was the inspiration for this?
Just my life, and just, you know what I'm saying, going through stuff and needing an outlet to get it out. So I write about all the stuff that I was going through on my journey, a lot of stuff I learned while I was going through the journey.
So how many books do you have written?
I have one that's out.
Right.
And I have a few that are finished, but they're going through certain drafts, so like I'm rewriting them and going back and making sure that they're perfect. But I have one that's out right now, and that's this one right here. But I'll have plenty more in the years to come.
Right. So you said you were coming out with the children's book, right?
Yeah.
What is that going to be about? And also, why a children's book?
I don't really want to go into the details of what it's about yet until it's out.
I can dig it.
But it's for black children. And it was inspired by the lack of representation that black children have when they look at stuff that's real towards children. A lot of times only white people and only white heroes, and anything that has, you know, a hue to it, usually a villain, or, you know what I'm saying, something that's ridiculed, something that people are taught not to associate with, even if it looks like you. So it was just inspired by an elder in the community. She was talking about how her grandson was like looking at all these white characters and stuff and was like, "Granny, how come I can't be white?" So I just wanted to have something that has a strong black hero in it, to where like black children can grow up and see someone who looks like them, to take pride in it and not feel like they gotta be embarrassed by, you know what I'm saying, not being white.
Right, very interesting. So you call yourself a poly...
Mathic wordsmith.
A polymathic wordsmith Smith. So what exactly is that?
That's like how Imhotep was a polymath, because like he did all these different things with medicine and architecture and all these things. A person who's a polymath is a person who's skilled at many things, So I'm a polymathic wordsmith. That means I'm skilled at writing all different types of things. So I write books, I write songs, I write films, I write plays and all these other things. So anything with writing, I'm good at. So that's what being a polymathic wordsmith.
Multi-talented. If people want the book, how do they reach you?
You can go to Marcus Books and cop one. You can also go to my website, forwardpublishinghouse.com. Forward is the mantra.
Are you on Facebook?
Yes, I am.
What's your name on Facebook?
Peace, y'all. My name is DeMareon Gibson, Brother Gibson, Gibson no Botula, and Blacksmith that Matters.
Is dedicated to helping Black entrepreneurs advertise their products and services. We are striving to provide a platform that Black consumers will utilize in effort to support Black-owned businesses. As you all know, Black businesses continue to struggle to maintain in today's economy where Blacks spend over $1 trillion on purchasing products and services in the U.S. There is no reason we as a people should struggle to have our own businesses when we possess that much spending power.